हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल. गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, लेट मी नो इन द चैट इफ आई एम नॉट ऑडिबल. हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग. लेट मी जस्ट क्विकली सेंड द रिमाइंडर इन द ग्रुप सो दैट एवरीबडी कैन जॉइन इन एंड वी विल स्टार्ट अ सेशन राइट नाउ. टाइम इज 6 PM. वी विल स्टार्ट अ सेशन इन 3-4 मिनट्स so that everybody join in and ready to attend the session. Okay, please let me know in the comments if you are able to hear. Good evening, good afternoon, whatever you want to say. Okay, so how many students here know basic web development? Like, have you created any website before? Anyone? Please let me know how much do you know HTML, CSS, JavaScript? How proficient you are in each one of them? Good evening, Bipin, Ankur, Dhaval, Deep, Dinesh, Divyanshu, Aditya. Very warm good evening to everyone. Let me know how good is your knowledge of HTML, CSS, and then JavaScript Bootstrap. We will start a session in few minute. Let everybody join in. Right now there is 6:01 in my watch and we will start at 6:05 almost. So in 4 minutes we will start the session. And if you are watching the recording of this session, then you can just skip this part, okay? And you can watch the video in the further part of this video. Sorry, watch the workshop in the further part of the video, okay? So today we are going to make the following ball game. We are going to talk about it a lot in the further part of our video. Good evening, Aditya, Ajay, Mahesh, Bipin, Kotana Lakshmi. Okay, you know the basics. Bipin ne IIT Kanpur se kara hai. Okay, hi, Ajaz, hi, Arshad. Good evening, Sukman. Yes, Tushar, good. Good evening, Anmol. So let me just send message in few more groups. Why my computer is stuck? So we will talk about first basics of JavaScript. First I will tell you what are DOM manipulation. So in this video we are not going to cover the HTML CSS part. In this game that we are going to make, there is hardly any HTML CSS. That's very limited, and we will provide you the code. You can just copy paste. It's very simple. You can very easily understand ki usme kya banaya ja raha hai, kya ho raha hai, uska kya purpose hai. Largely what you have to learn is the JavaScript, the logic behind it, and why we are doing every single part of it. That is really complicated and difficult to do for a beginner, okay? While this HTML CSS part is very simple, okay? So we'll talk about extensively about the JavaScript part. First we'll tell you what is DOM manipulation, how you can perform basic DOM manipulation. Then we'll talk about functions and events that we are going to use in this workshop. Then we are going to talk about the logic of the game we are going to develop, and then we will start working on the game. So this session is going to be around 40 to 45 minutes where we'll be covering whole of the game. And my recommendation would be that you first watch the session, ask all your queries, ask your doubts, and when this session ends, then you afterwards go and start making the whole project on your own, and then you can re-watch the session as well, okay? So don't code alongside, because that will be very confusing for you. First understand how to make it, everything, etc., and then code it yourself, okay? So this should be the perfect path you have to follow. Let me explain you all the links which are there in the description and how you can take the best advantage of them. I am just sending the message. My computer is stuck. So what are the comments coming? Okay, Harsh, very good. You are from Agra. Nice to meet you. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so far. Okay, we will start the session in 1 minute. Right now time is 6:04. I will share my screen and show you the further part of this workshop. If you haven't registered for this workshop and you want certificate, then please register in the link in the description. If you don't want certificate, then there is no need to register. You can just watch the session for knowledge, okay? Yeah, so we are about to start. Good evening, good evening. Badhiya, badhiya. Please check the links in the description. I will also explain you in a moment. Once my computer allows me to do. Okay, so this part is done. Okay, Utsav, you are from Ghaziabad. Very good. Good evening, Harshit. Okay, everyone has seen the game, na? Like, what exactly, which game we are going to make? Everyone has seen the demo link that I have shared to you. Is there anyone who hasn't seen the game? So please watch the game, check the game, how it is going to work, because then only you will understand how to make it. So please explore, play it on your own, and then we will start the session in a minute. Okay? Just last forward is left, then we will start. Also, this recording will be available on this link forever. So if you don't want to watch the live, if you have something to do, exam or anything, any homework, you can definitely watch the video later as well. Good evening, Magadhi Jokes Factory. Okay, Ashutosh Pandey, very good. Just one second more. Ashish Tiwari, link of game Shubhankar, link is there in the description. You can check in the description of the same video in which live session is happening. You can check in the description. There are 3-4 links. I am going to explain you how you can take advantage of each link. Okay, my forwarding has been done. My WhatsApp is closed now. Okay, so the students who are joining right now, so let me explain you what all things you have to check in the description. First, let me share my screen with you, right? Because you don't want to just see my face. चल क्यों नहीं रहा है डेमो वाला? आशुतोष पांडे, आपको चलाना नहीं आ रहा? अभी हम खिला के दिखाते हैं आपको. निश्चिंत रहें. आई थिंक यू आर एबल टू सी माई स्क्रीन नाउ. लेट मी नो इन द कॉमेंट्स. ठीक है, सो आ जाते हैं वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में एक बार. हम लेट्स गो टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द वीडियो. लेट मी शो यू ऑल द लिंक्स एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट अ वर्कशॉप. दिल बेचारा ऑफिशियल प्रोमो क्या क्या दिखाते रहते हैं. ठीक है, सो यू विल सी सम लिंक्स इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द सेम वीडियो. फर्स्ट इज द रजिस्टर हेयर फॉर सर्टिफिकेट. नेक्स्ट इज द मर्नस्टैक इंटर्नशिप बूट कैंप, वील टॉक अबाउट इट लेटर. वेब डेवलपमेंट इंटर्नशिप, वील टॉक अबाउट इट लेटर. थर्ड लिंक इज द नोट्स. सो देर इज द डॉक्यूमेंट दैट वी हैव शेयर्ड विद यू दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट, विच कंटेन्स all the information that we are going to discuss step by step details of this workshop. So you can check out this document. I will explain about it later. Next is the working demo of the code of the game. So next link you see, this game is here. Link to working demo, beat zero GitHub. Okay, so in this game is work like this. You have to keep it like right, left. You have to follow the ball in the spaces. Okay, so it's a very simple game that you can make in 30 to 40 minutes. Okay, you can also make very complex game, but the first game you can make, it's very simple. You will get out when you miss to jump this space, then it will show you a score which is 17. It's a very simple game. Okay, so the original creator of this game is Knife Circus. So I want to give them the credits. You can check their original tutorial. They have lots of good tutorials JavaScript on their YouTube channel, so you can also learn from them. So as a community, we must help each other because we have taken inspiration from their code. Okay, so thank you Knife Circus for creating this good tutorial. Keep up the good work. Last link you will see is link to the code that we are going to discuss today. I will explain the code to you later. Okay, so index.html, script.js, style.css, every code that we are going to use today is provided to you in the description of the video. Okay, okay, great. So let's start this session. Okay, so let me first show you what are we are going to discuss today. So we are not going to study HTML CSS today. I expect you to learn HTML CSS on your own. In this session, there is no need of HTML CSS per se. So we are just focusing on the what part? JavaScript part. So I'm going to show you the JavaScript part only. Okay, let me just take in one second. So we are going to take part of just the JavaScript part. I will give you the CSS and HTML code. So first we'll talk about what is JavaScript. DOM manipulation. DOM is document object module. Like if you see any web page, let's say if you see our website web page, if you go to view page source, okay, so you will see there is a structure of the website that has been followed. Sabse upar hamara aata hai HTML tag. There is head tag in that and head closing tag. Tag within head you will see lots of tag like meta, link, title, etc. Then you will go to the body tag. Then you will go to nav tag, div tag. So there are lots of tags within tags. So this is structure is called document object model. Okay. So if we want to do some changes in this model, it's called manipulation. We can do this with the help of JavaScript. We are giving you three simple examples how you can do JavaScript manipulation. I am giving you a basic idea right now, but in the further part of this workshop, we are going to see live demonstration code. Hum run karke dekhenge ki kaise manipulation aapka live karta hai, kyunki is jo game hum banane ja rahe hai usme it is very very useful and it will be used at many parts. So what do you understand by what is JavaScript DOM manipulation? Can anybody explain me in the chat? Let's understand more about it, okay, so that you don't get confused. So one of the most common things you will want to do is manipulate the document structure. Like there is HTML tag, there is body tag, there is div tag, there is span tag. So this is the structure of a web page. If you want to manipulate it, this is usually done by using the DOM document object model, a set of API, or you can say a method properties with which you can do the changes. Okay, everybody clear what is DOM? Anyone who doesn't understand what is DOM, because this is very beginner level stuff that you need to know if you want to work in a JavaScript based framework or even in web development. So can anyone explain me in the chat what do you understand by DOM? Please let me know. I will read out your comment. Okay, then we'll move forward. Till then, let me tell you about a 1 month internship bootcamp that we are conducting in Jan. So it will be starting from 3rd Jan. So it will be 12 live sessions of 2 hours each, 7 to 9 p.m. on Monday, Wednesday and Friday it will be conducted. So what we are going to teach, we are going to teach you JavaScript from basics. Okay, we will give some revision of HTML, CSS as well, but this is an advanced course. We'll teach you JavaScript from basics, then we'll teach you React.js, React.js second session, then we'll teach you Node.js, database, you will be learning MongoDB, etc. And then we will be making you three projects will be made into this. First is this Instagram clone. So this is the project that will be taught in this. Everything will be taught to you live in the session and you have to just follow whatever is told to you, and live doubts will be taken. So you can see the profile of this devil guy. Okay, so these kind of features you can make in this Instagram project. Second is the Breaking Bad wiki. You can search any characters you like, Jesse Pinkman, etc. Third is a portfolio website that you can create with the help of React. So you can definitely join our bootcamp. Link is there in the description. You will also get 2 certificates. One certificate is of bootcamp completion. Second is of internship, of 1 month internship, which details like what all you studied, like which specific topic, which projects you worked upon. I know certificate is not a perfect criteria, but some colleges and some company ask for them, so you can show it there. Okay, so this is advanced month stack. Okay, bootcamp is starting from 3rd of January. There will be a batch in February as well. So if you have your exams in Jan, you can join in February. Okay, so if you have any query, let me know. Link is there in the description. Okay, so anyone answered what is DOM? Okay, Kushagri, DOM, we can select a tag. Okay, it's not that correct. Okay, please work on the definition. Okay, I think DOM you have understood. If you haven't understood, please let me know in the comments. Then we'll discuss about it later. Okay, so in DOM manipulation, we are going to discuss 3 parts. JavaScript can change HTML content, that we can change the initial internal content of any div. Let's say maine ek div banaya. I hope you know what is div. And we have added some content into it. I want to change it. So what I will do? I will call document. It is an object which is available, which Deep will tell you in the further part of the workshop. I am giving you an overview so that ki jab aap aage jao to aapko ye na lage ki sir kya bole ja rahe hai, I am not able to understand anything. So I am telling you a brief in 5 minutes, then we'll go to the main workshop. Okay, Document is the object available to you. Get element by ID. Every div or span you can give the ID, you can give the class. I hope you are aware of that. Then you can call it by that. You can call it dot inner HTML and you can place the value. So inner HTML will be replaced. Alternatively, you can also use text content if you just want to add the content. Okay, so first part is you can change the HTML content here. Second, you can change the HTML attribute value. For example, you know there is an image tag. So in my image, you can change the src, the URL of the image that you are displaying. Okay. Apart from this, you can also change the CSS in which you can, for example, change the font size, background color, you can change image, you want to change anything, you can do anything here. Everything is available in JavaScript as well, which is available to you in CSS. If you even don't know this kind of basic level of HTML CSS, you can definitely join our web development bootcamp, which is starting from 4th of January. It is going to same. 12 live sessions will happen. Total of 24 hours will be taught to you, 7 to 9 p.m. on Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. 3 days classes will happen. It will start from very basics of HTML, very basics of CSS, Bootstrap, HTML basics, CSS basics, Bootstrap, portfolio website will be created. Then we'll teach you JavaScript, jQuery, Ajax, then COVID tracker, CSS website will be created. So there will be 3 websites taught to you, the whole theory, and 2 certificates. This is bootcamp completion and this is certificate of internship. And let me show you the websites and then we will continue to the workshop. Deep is going to take the workshop and he is also the instructor of our bootcamp. So you will get an idea how the bootcamp is going to be. Okay, so this is the SAS website. We are going to teach you. Everything will be taught to you in details in the workshop. Bootcamp, and you can ask your queries if you have any. It's a proper responsive functional website. Okay, you can check out the details, link is there in the description. This is the COVID tracker that you can create. This is the portfolio website. It is also there in MERN stack as well, but in MERN you are going to make it with React, but here you are making it with HTML and CSS. Okay. So Deep, you can share your screen now. So let me also explain you the code of this workshop. 1 second. Let me also explain you the code of this workshop so that you don't get confused. Kya copy karna hai, kya nahi karna hai. Very good, Kalyani Gunwanti. Let me also explain you the code. What are the files we are going to use? The GitHub link we have shared. So it will take me 30 seconds and then we will start the code. Deep will teach you. Go to link to code. You have to copy the code from here, okay? So if you want to make explain you the code of yourself, okay? So when you open there, you will see this repository fall game. Click on this. And you will see 3 files here. Let's go to index.html. You will see there is a very simple code, simple HTML tag, head, title, body. And there is only 1 div, ID game, and internal div, ID character. That's it. Nothing else. Script is included here and CSS is also included here. Nothing else is there. Isme kuch bhi seekhna nahi hai. Just copy paste this file. Second is the style.css.
Yeah, okay, sir.
So
let me also explain you the code of this workshop.
Arre, pause karo bhai. Kya kar rahe ho? Mute karo audio.
Explain you the code of this workshop.
Audio mute karo bhai. Mera kyu repeat kar rahe ho? Okay, so sorry for the disturbance. So if you look at the CSS code, it's very simple. Game ID, character ID, block ID, only 3-4 rules are written here. These are very simple, you can understand. So what is the major code we are going to understand is in the script.js file. You can see it's 112 lines. We are going to teach every part of it line by line. Don't worry, it's a lot of code. Don't worry, we'll teach you all of it. Okay, so this is going to be, you have to write the JS file. Rest of the code you can copy it from here itself. Okay, any query to anyone? And also let me tell you about the certificate. You will get the certificate on your WhatsApp number with which you have registered. So I will send you a message in 4 to 5 days with instructions on how to get your certificate. Okay, so no need to worry, you will get in 4 to 5 days. Okay, any query to anyone, please let me know. I am handing it over to Deep, then he will be taking all your queries. Deep, you have opened the chat in your phone.
यस सर।
ओके गुड, सो प्लीज शेयर योर स्क्रीन।
ओके सर, सो आई एम ऑडिबल ना?
यस यस।
ओके सर,
so give us a second guys, Deep will take the video workshop from here, give us a second to set up everything.
So I guess my screen is presenting right now.
Yes, your screen is presenting.
Okay sir. So hello everyone, my name is Deep Chaudhary and I'm a student at GCT and part-time instructor at Two Wits. And from now I'll be taking a workshop. So I think Achint sir already explained this DOM manipulation and JavaScript part, like little bit JavaScript part. So
start with the code part, okay?
Start with the code part, yeah. Okay. So I think you already know the HTML, CSS, and the little bit JavaScript. So we can just move to the code part, right? So let me just show you what we are going to make. So this is our basic game, right? So what can we do in the game? Like it's a simple, pretty basic game actually of JavaScript. We made it with the help of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, right? And you can play this game, right? So this is a small game which we are going to make. Okay, so let me show you the code, and if you have any doubt or something, then you can just comment them. Okay, I will be checking your comments after every 5 minutes. Okay, so okay, so this is your HTML part, right? This is your index.html file. I'm assuming that you already know the HTML and CSS part. Okay, we'll be going to focus on the JavaScript part, and this is your CSS part. Okay, so as you can see, we chose this game because
I show them the steps in the document.
Steps in the document, okay.
So we have divided the whole process of this logic into 10 or 12 steps. So that it's very easy for you to contextualize कि हर step पे हम क्या कर रहे हैं, ठीक है?
Yeah. So we are going to follow these steps so that we can make
Please don't process. Send request to this session. What are you going to do by joining here? Okay.
Okay. Nice. So these are some steps. Okay. I think Achint sir already shared this document to you. So if you want, you can open this document in your phone also. It's not compulsory, but anyways, so let me just show you the JavaScript part first, then I'll be going to type the whole code. Okay, so this is your JavaScript code. As you can see, we've used everything. Okay, like we are taking the character and the movelet function. I will explain everything. Okay, I will explain the purpose of every function in this JavaScript. Okay, so this is our complete JavaScript code. So anyways, so I'm hoping that you already know how to add JavaScript in the HTML, okay, how to add CSS and something. So these are pretty basic actually. So I'm not writing the JavaScript code in this HTML file. I'm writing it externally. Okay, so I named it script2.js and then attached it in the script section, right? Okay, so when I save this, you can see what is here. Yeah, nothing. It has all simple division, okay, with a red circle in it, right? So there are no black blocks or something, because we added all those blocks and everything with the help of JavaScript. Okay, right. Now first, what are we going to do? we are going to this character. Okay, what is this character? This character is this ball. Okay, so our first step is first save the character division in variables and make the logic to move the ball towards left and right. Okay, so that's exactly what we are going to do. First, I save this character. The ID was character. Okay. As I guess, Achin sir already told you that we can get access of particular element, particular HTML element in the JavaScript through dot get element by ID, dot get element by tag name, by classes. There are several ways to do that. Now I'm going to make some function. First function 4, I guess move left. And what I'll do in this function, I'll make a variable here. Let's say it's left, and then I'll convert it into the
int. थोड़ा स्क्रीन को ज़ूम कर लो, थोड़ा सा टेक्स्ट को कोड
पे. Okay. So is it all right right now?
थोड़ा और कर लो.
Okay. Right now.
Yes.
So is it good?
Right yes, now? Go ahead.
Okay, I can start. Okay, thank you. Now, so let's just make this parseInt function. And then in this parseInt, what we'll do, we'll use a window. I think you guys know about the BOM, the browser object model. Okay, it is nothing but we can use the Windows function with the help of it. If you don't understand it or don't know it, this is not going to be a problem. We are just using a function. Okay. It is computer style. The computer style, say character, this character we are talking about. And then dot get property. And point left. And then I'll say what I'm doing exactly, first I save this left. Okay, what is this property? This is the property of going any character to the left. Okay, like if I want to move this ball to the left, okay, to the left, so first I save this property in the left variable, and then what I'll do, I say I will style it. What is styling? The CSS part, okay, which we are doing in the JavaScript. Okay? Because to move the position of any character is the CSS part, if I'm not wrong, right? So style dot left is equal to the left, this left, okay, and then minus two. We want to go to the left, right? So that's why we are going minus two. Okay, like if our left is here, then minus two would be here, right? Okay, so and we are talking in pixels. Okay, there are so many things, so many matrices in which we can change the position of any element, like pixels, point, percentage. We are doing it in pixel. Okay, so this is four move left. Okay, and we'll do the same for move right. But there would be a difference. We took the position of it and then plus two. Okay. So why I say plus two here? Because if our left position is here, then the plus two would be 2 pixels from this position. Okay. Now I'm going to add some event listener. Okay, our step two. Make logic for key pair generated event handling. Okay. We are going to handle the event. What is event? Like when someone or our user presses the key, what should happen? Right. So we do it with the help of event add event listener. Okay. So what do we do? Document dot add event listener. And in what event we are talking about? We are talking about pressing the key. So we used key down keyword. Yeah. And then what should we do? We pass the event and make a arrow function. Okay. The arrow function is a normal function. Okay. It is just a syntax. We cannot write the function keyword here. Means it's not much convenient. It would be not much convenient. So that's why we are using arrow function. Okay. It's a part of modern JavaScript. And then I'll check the condition. If our pressed key is the arrow left key. Right. Equal to arrow left key. And please let me know if you have any doubt or you don't understand any part. Okay, I'll please write them in the comment. Okay, I'll solve it when I read the comment. Okay. So event dot key, and what should we do right now? Let's say we make a variable interval here. Interval variable. Okay, we will just declare it. Okay, we will not pass any value in it. Okay, it's an interval. And we'll use set interval function here. So I hope you already know set interval function, but if you don't know, it is just a basic function in which we can pass the time. Okay, we can pass the seconds. Like after this second, the function should be executed. Okay, so now what do you want? If our key, the pressed key, is the arrow left key, then I'll say pass the function move left, right? And then the time period would be of 1, and then we'll handle the second event would be 4, right? So arrow right. Okay. So, and then move it. So this is our normal function. Right. Now we can see that if we pressed our key, okay, we press our left arrow key, suppose, then what would happen? This set interval, the move left function would run, right? And then we didn't pass any condition or something to stop it, right? So the what condition we'll pass the release condition. Okay, we'll pass another event listener in which for releasing the key. Okay. Now document dot add event is na. And for releasing the key, we use key up. Okay. And now the event here is in the same arrow function here. And then what we'll do, we'll use a function clear interval. Means it will stop everything what is going on inside this set interval function. Now clear interval will pass, we have to tell it what interval we are talking about. So we will pass this interval. Okay, it will clear this interval right now. I think you may think that our problem is solved, but no, there is another condition. What condition would it be? If we press both the key, right? If we press both the key, what would happen? It will go either to the left, either to or to the right. Okay, so to handle that condition, we'll pass another variable. Okay, variable both is equal to zero. And then I'll put that condition here, say that if both is equal to zero, not this, we are comparing it. Okay, we use double arrow function for comparing, for comparison. Okay, then I'll say both plus plus. Okay. And then I'll pass this condition. Inside this condition, okay, so it will handle our both case. Okay, now and when we release the key, say both should be zero. Okay, we'll pass the zero again to the boot. Okay, so okay, it should do the thing. Okay, then our next step is, yeah, we already checked if the condition, if both keys are pressed. Okay, and then the fourth step is make block and hold variables. Okay, why are we building the block and hold? Because you can see there aren't any blocks, black blocks, which you were seeing in the running game, like. Right, there aren't any blocks or something, so we have to make them with the help of JavaScript. But I think I forgot one condition. Yeah, to the left condition. Yeah, if we press this left key, okay, single left key, and then release it, it can go to the infinity, right? But we don't want it to go outside of this box, of this division. So we have to pass some conditions for it. So for the right, for the left actually first. For the left, I'll say, if left is greater than zero, then move the left. Is for the left, okay, here. And for this, if this is 380, okay, and this value, I passed this value in the CSS, okay, that's why I'm passing it here. So we cannot, our this circle, this ball will not go outside of this division, of this box. Okay, so this condition is handled. then I think I'll make block and holes. Okay, so for them, just make two variables, blocks, not blocks, just a block, okay, block, and then document dot create element. We are using create element to create the text or, you know, any element of the HTML, right? So create elements, create element, and we'll pass which element we want to create, right? So we want to create a division, so that's why we passed this div tag, okay? And then the same for hole. And then I think you already saw in the PDF that we can change the attribute also. So let's pass some class into the block and holes. Okay. So we use set attribute for this task. Then say I have to make a class. And then block, and then same for hole. Sorry, I didn't change this name here. This hole, okay. Like you already saw that in the game, there were a block, okay. There were a block with a hole in it, right? So we are creating this both elements. And same for and okay, great. Now we have to append them. Like we created these divisions, but we have to add them to any other divisions which is already present in the HTML. Okay, so that's how we can actually add these divisions in our HTML page. Okay, so we are going to add those blocks and hole inside this game division. So how do we do it? We use a function called append child. So first I have to get that division. It's same as now would be of game. The name would be game, okay, and then the ID name is also game. We got this division with ID game inside this variable game. Okay, so now we can do whatever we want to do with it. Okay, so let's say game dot append child.
How much is left, Deep?
Sir, I guess 20 to 30 minutes I can.
Okay.
It can take.
Continue.
2025. Okay. Yeah. Client, okay, and then block. One for block, one for hold. Okay. Okay, great. Now let's see that if we have a. Okay, now we have a hole. This thing is hole. Okay, and this thing is block inside this game division. Okay, so we don't want it in this way, right? We want it to come in the random way, right? So just make a random function.
थोड़ा सा स्पीड बढ़ा लो.
ओके ओके सर. यस या सो वी क्रिएट अ न्यू रैंडम फंक्शन. एंड देन वी यूज द मैथ डॉट फ्लोर फंक्शन, राइट?
हेलो एवरीवन, यू डोंट हैव टू सबमिट द कोड. But it is always advised that you make the code and host it on your GitHub. It will add for your profile and it will be good. You can just create a separate repository for this falling ball game. Okay, so that will be good for your profile. You don't have to submit, but it is advised that you make and upload on your GitHub. Okay.
So we've created a random function here, random variable. Okay. And then what we'll do? We'll put an style into it. So whole dot style dot left, okay, be equal to random is this. It will create a random number, random plus pixels, okay. So we've created a random function, random variable. Let's see. Okay. Every time we refresh it, the hole would be on another position, right? So this is what our random function is doing. Now, put these things into the set interval function. And then function this whole block inside this set interval function and okay, so now we are going to like the hole is coming, okay, this hole is coming, but we want it to coming it to goes from up to down, right? Okay, so we'll put a condition, not condition, we'll make the block last. It is last. Okay. So block last is equal to document dot get element by ID. We are getting block. Okay, and then plus. Okay, so let's make a counter. Okay, to count this number of blocks. Okay. We have to show the score last, right? So we have to keep counting the number, right? So let's initialize it with 0, and then block plus counter minus 1. Same for hole. We'll do everything, most of the things same for block and hole both. Okay. So, okay. So this is for hole last. And it will get the hole. Okay. And then we'll set our condition that if counter is greater than zero. Like we have to build these blocks if our counter is more than zero, right? So here we'll make another variable, which is block last. I guess, yeah. We are getting the top and left position. Okay, we'll be getting the top position for hole, and the block. Okay, like right now you can see these are coming from the left, but we don't want it coming from the left. We want it coming from the up and go to down. Right, or to go from down to goes to, you know. So parse int, and then the same function windows dot computed get computed style. Here we'll pass block last. And then pass this property value top. We want it on the top, right? We want our block to be on the top. And then okay, so make another one for hole. But we want our hole, hole also on the top. Okay, so, okay, sorry. Okay. Now. We'll set another condition here. Like if block large top is greater than 400. Okay. The 400 is the length of this. Okay. Sorry, height of this. Sorry. Yeah. If the condition, and then another condition would be the counter should be equal to zero. Then put this whole code inside this inside these conditions, right? Now set another attribute for these block and hole. So we already set the class. Now we'll set the ID for block. The ID would be block plus. Right. This would be this. Now, it should be for hole. Okay, hole plus counter. We've made these ID attributes too. Now we want it coming from the top. Okay, so say let's do the new styling block style dot. Top, block last top, yes, block last top plus 100. Okay, and we'll do it. We'll do it also in pixel. Okay. then same for code. Okay. Use whole last stop. Okay, so we appended them. Okay, so let's see what it's doing. It's coming. Now we have to do the counter plus plus actually. Sorry, I didn't delete it. So we want it right here. Now you can see our main task is, and then you can see the when we refresh it, the hole would be at the at another position. Right. So now our another task is to move this ball on this. On these blocks, okay. Like if these blocks are going up, our ball also should be going up, okay. So, let's say we have to make an array. We have the current blocks. We are making an empty array. And then we are pushing counter in it. I guess the name was counter current blocks actually. Current blocks, how do we add element in the array? In the JavaScript, okay? We use push. So we can use push, pop, everything, add. Okay, there, because there is only array. There is no concept of stack and queue or another data structure in the JavaScript. Okay. So that's why we are using the stack property or function in this array. Okay, because in JavaScript there is only array. So then make another character top. Okay, these whole things we are doing for the ball. Up is equal to parseInt and another boom function window dot at computed the character. What is the character? Character is our ball. Okay, I hope you are getting this. Property value, then we'll define top here. Now this is for character top, and then make another variable for character left. It would be same to the top, but the difference is we are using left here. Okay, this is character left. We named it F. Okay, great. Now, make an variable drop 0. Okay. Drop is equal to 0. Okay, make a variable drop and initialize it with 0. And say this is for if we drop the ball, like in which condition we should drop the ball, right? So we made this variable for that condition. Okay, you'll understand later in this code. And then put a condition that if character top is lesser than or equal to zero. Okay, this is the condition. We'll handle it in the last. Okay, this is the condition for like as you saw that when we like whenever ball goes up, okay, and we lost the game, then our alert box, like the an alert box showed in at the top of the screen, okay, where it shows our scores, like how much blocks we crossed. Okay, so that functionality can be occurred due to this condition. Sorry. Okay, and then okay, so now make a loop. Current blocks dot length. Okay, I guess you're understanding the concept of this, right? And now we are initializing a variable current. Current blocks are we are getting one the we are getting the first element of this
there
array.
Is some disturbances coming slightly in audio
from my side.
Yes, I think so.
Let me just check the headphone.
Check it for 5 seconds. Okay?
Yes, sir. Is it now?
Speak something, then I'll tell.
Hello?
Yes, it's better. Yes,
all right.
Better now.
Yeah, okay, thank you, sir. Now, make another, let's say, I block. We are getting a block in this kind. Let's just use the get element by ID function. Block. And sorry for the disturbance, guys. I'm in my home. So.
Bye bye.
Just neighbors. just give me a second, guys. Mummy, अरे शोर कम मचा हुआ यार, शोर कम मचा हुआ यार. Okay, sorry guys. Now.
Someone was also asking the difference in let and where.
Let and where, okay, it's a very good question actually. See, when I used where, okay, so I can use this character top inside this whole code if I'm using a variable through where keyword. But if I'm using this let keyword, I can use this current variable inside this scope.
Okay, so it's for local variable and that is for global variable.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Continue.
Yeah, okay. So now the I hold. Okay. Hello Achin sir, if there is any issue about time, then I can like there is a little bit code, so I can just copy it from the another file if there is any time issue or something.
Copy
or
hello, can... time kafi ho gaya, 1 ghanta ho gaya.
Yeah, okay, that's why I asked.
Because it's same, right? So you no need to.
Yeah, it's totally same, there is no difference.
Okay,
I will explain it anyways, so it won't make much difference like whether I type it or not. yeah, our game is running. You can see. So let me just explain you the for loop, okay? See, we've created an I block, okay, and I block variable and save this block plus current, okay, current is block, but like if our ball is on this block, right? Like if I didn't put the condition at that place, so that's why it is going like this, okay? So like our ball is on that block, so that is our current block, so that is what we are going to save this in this I block and I hole, okay? So if our I block top, okay, if our I block top, this one, we can get it through this I block and set its property to the top, okay? And same for the left, okay? And then what? Then I'll do some styling, okay? I'll put some CSS inside this I block top, and then I take these conditions, okay? Like if I block top is lesser than minus 20, then shift the blocks, okay, and then remove the current I block and remove the and current I hole, right? So if this goes up, we are removing it, okay? So that's what we are doing through this function. And then in the last, if drop is equal to zero, yeah, so this this code is for we are dropping this ball, right? Like if this ball goes up, then it should generate a condition. We'll create this condition here. Sorry. We'll create this condition in this. Where was it? Yeah, here. It is nothing but a condition in which we show the pop-up box, okay, using alert function. Okay. These three lines are for the condition. Now you can see, now we are getting a scoreboard. So that condition was for the, yeah. When we click OK, I just refreshed the game. That's why it's loading actually. I'm starting it again, so no worry. Yeah. Now you can see it again. Right. So yeah, that was our whole code. So if anyone has any doubt or something, then they can ask. Ajit, did I miss any doubt or something? And of course, if anyone finds it lengthy or like little bit complex, then it's a JavaScript, okay? If you just watch some video or something of JavaScript, then you'll understand it quite well, okay? It is not very difficult. It was not very difficult. It was actually very easy, okay? It was just a very basic game, okay, which we built.
It's a very beginner level game. You can start your journey of JavaScript with something like this. But first, if you are a beginner, you should make more simpler code than this. Okay. So you should make like adding items to a cart. Okay. So these kind of basic things you should make. But if you want to work in this gaming animation domain, then this is a very basic. इससे simple कुछ नहीं आएगा. इससे simple बस ये आएगा कि block को rotate कर दिया है ना, left right उसको करा दिया. Okay, so that kind of games will be there. If you want to learn further in this domain, then the same YouTube channel that I have suggested to you, Knife Circus. Okay, so if you want to make more such game, you can go to the web YouTube channel of Knife Circus and you will find.
I will keep.
तो यू कैन गो टू दिस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड मेक मोर गेम्स एज वेल. ओके, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट सम मोर मेंटोरशिप एंड मोर गाइडेंस देन यू कैन डेफिनेटली ज्वाइन आर बूट कैंप, 1 month internship bootcamp. We are going to teach you everything in depth. In this session, you are connected via YouTube. Our bootcamps happen on Google Meet, and so that you can ask your questions as well. And you will just ask your questions on Google Meet live. So all your queries will be resolved. It's a 30 days bootcamp. 12 sessions will happen on 3 days per week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Definitely check the details. Batch will start from 3rd of Jan. If you have exams in January, you can join our batch in February. So we will have the Feb batch after the GATE exam. GATE exam is, I think, at 14th Feb, right? So we will have the batch after that. So don't worry about it. So you can definitely look forward to joining it. Making these three websites, Instagram clone, Breaking Bad Wiki, Portfolio, and Learning with Deep Chaudhary. Okay, if you have any queries, stone, paper, scissor, yes, Kushagri, you can make that as well. So all the link are there in the description. I would recommend you to work on this code. And if you need any help, you can comment on this video. We will reply to your queries. Okay, so if you have any query, you can just comment on this video. It will be available on the same link. And if you want to refer to the code, code is there in the description. If you want to read the notes which were discussed, that is also there in the description. Demo is also there in the description. I would really recommend you to make this code all by yourself. Just copy the HTML and CSS code, make all JavaScript line by line, host it on your GitHub profile. It will definitely boost your GitHub profile. Okay, that will later help you in your profile. Okay, kindly share for deploying the game online. Okay, let me show you the deploying as well. You can go to our YouTube channel. So that's a very simple process. You have to just host it on GitHub pages. Go to your YouTube channel. There is a video on GitHub pages. If you have any other queries, please ask fast because we are about to end this session. So we conducted a similar workshop on April, which was on how to host a website on GitHub pages. I think we can also do it again, Deep, right? It's been a long while.
Yes, again. Yes, obviously. You can do it.
So you can definitely look into it. You will get your certificate in 4-5 days. Okay, so if you have any query, comment on the video. If you want to join bootcamp, you can WhatsApp me if you have any query. Okay, thank you, Deep, for your time. Thanks for teaching our students. Okay, you can go. So I'm about to end the session. If you have any query, please ask fast. We are waiting for 1 more minute. And if you have been watching the recorded video, so you can definitely follow the steps and make the game. Okay, thank you so much everyone for joining in.